we're looking at assessing deposition in stubble, particularly in summertime, because one of the issues that we have on most machines is problems in the wheel tracks and issues with dust in around the wheels. So what we've been doing is positioning water sensitive paper down in amongst the stubble, but also in the interrow. And it's important to have a reference point when you do that. So when checking across the machine, we'll start out on the boom and see what the deposition should be without interference, and then we'll come back into the machine. So what we'll do is check some deposition in the standing stubble out on the boom here. Okay, we're about the midpoint of the boom out from the machine, and we've placed the cards in the interrow or between the standing stubble, but also at the base. And what we're looking for is comparing the deposition between the two areas. So looking at where the droplets are landed, seeing if there's enough coverage there, and we're going to use this as a reference point. And the things we're looking for on this water-sensitive paper or cards is how even that is between the two. And if we get to the point where these are pretty even, it's a great reference point. So on this we can see fairly uniform droplets. We've actually used a core spectrum here at about 80 litres of water, and the two cards look very similar. Now we can use app-based programs like SnapCard to actually measure that deposition as a percentage coverage, and we can see how close it is, because quite often with a naked eye, they'll look similar, but then you might not pick up the subtle differences. But these two, to me, look pretty even, and they'll form our reference point for comparing the other cards in closer to the machine. So whatever happens here out on the boom, we'll be comparing other parts of the boom, particularly around the wheel tracks in the centre of the machine, to see if it's as good as it is here. Now, if we see any issues between these, like differences between what's happening in the interrow and the stubble line, particularly reductions in the stubble, that should be a cue to us that we need to change something, either volume or pressure, or maybe manipulate droplet size a little bit. So this is our reference point. If we get this right across the boom, then we can go in and have a look at the centre and see if there's anything else we need to adjust to tweak the wheel tracks or manipulate for dust. We're moving into the wheel track area of the machine now. This is a really important focus for summer fallow spraying, not only for dust, but looking at what's going on around the wheel track. So we're looking at either outside the wheel or inside the wheel. And coming down to the cards, this one placed on the outside of the tyre. So we're comparing what's going on in the interrow to the standing stubble. And I can see in the standing stubble on the outside of the tyre, the deposition is quite a bit lower on this card. If I come to the inside of the tyre over here, again, if we look at what's going on here in the standing stubble, you can see the deposition is a lot less there in the standing stubble. So what I'm going to do is go have a look at the setup on the machine, see where the nozzles are, and see if we can make some improvements. We come in to look at the nozzle setup on this machine, and I can see it's a dual boom, and that in and around the wheel itself, they've actually got a larger nozzle on here to increase the flow rate, which is very common for most operators. They'll increase the flow on the wheel to try and deal with dust and wheel track issues. But what we've seen is that the problem is actually also on the outside of the wheel. So rather just increasing the flow rate in one spot by, in this case, including a bigger nozzle, what we should do is probably spread that flow, or at least look at outside of either side of the wheel to try and even up that deposition, and then run those tests again to see how well we've done. And once we've done that, we could look at other areas on the machine. So while we're doing the same test, I tend to not only focus on the outside of the boom and the wheel tracks, I'll take a measurement in the centre on these particular wheels, inside and outside on the other wheel, and also out on the centre of the boom, and make the same comparisons. Remembering that our reference point is what's going on out in the boom, and if we see any differences in the centre around the wheels, this is where we're trying to improve things to get our fallow spraying to be a little bit better.